The land located at plot 71 Kuruma Road was leased to MS Securex Amenities Limited on condition that two floors would be condominium property of a KCCA, but the developer never fulfilled the condition and has now converted the leasehold into a freehold under controversial circumstances.
Saying it housed a health center belonging to KCC, the health center ceased to be. Now there is a mall, and so we were questioning how property moved from KCC to now a private individual. The current SKCCA establishment said, look, we are not in agreement with what was done, but it is not us who did it. Time has lapsed. We cannot even run to court. We shall be wasting taxpayers' money and all of these different things. But ultimately, we must be able to hold somebody or some people accountable.
In correspondences shared with MPs, former Kampala Mayor Nasantege Sebagala asked then Town Clerk Ruth Kijambu to clear the acquisition by MS Securex. In response, however, Ms. Kijambu asked the then mayor to discuss the matter in the executive committee, which purportedly approved the said acquisition. Appearing before the committee today, Kijambu disowned the correspondences purporting to bear her signature, terming them as a forgery.
Now, as I look at this letter, yes, the signature seems to be similar to mine, but I'm not sure whether somebody didn't scan my signature and put that condition, because my memory, two floors were specifically supposed to be for a health center. So I'm not sure whether this is my signature.
KCC said, look, it's okay, go ahead, as long as two floors remain for the health center. So a lease is granted to Securex, 5 years, then renewed. Under what circumstances? Want to understand from Uganda Land Commission's standing, was this lease fulfilled to the letter?
MPs also learned from the Auditor General that by the time MS Securex was allocated the lease, it wasn't incorporated as a company, and that the file containing all the correspondences incidental to the impugned transaction has since been confirmed missing by officials from the Uganda Land Commission.
The report indicates that the lease of this plot was handled hastily under shrewdly and dubious circumstances that included, one, approving allocation of this strategic asset to a company, MS Securex Limited, on 21st April 2010, which was not in existence since it was incorporated on 27th May 2010. So this Securex company, and again the details, you saw the shareholders, 80%, one Taganda, Ephraim, then there was 10%, another 10% by two people, within the documents,
but Chair,
was incorporated on 27th May 2010.
Chair.
But the lease was granted on 21st April 2010. So all these are issues that we need to be pointing to clearly show how this whole transaction was tainted by fraud.
For me, even me, I'm not in support of the fraud that was made in the process of giving out that plot 71 Kuruma Road, where was a facility of the hospital of KCCA. If the fraud reached to the extent of giving a company, awarding a company which was not registered yet, done. That is a super fraud.
The MPs pointed at a web of corrupt officials who are complicit in such dubious transactions. They criticized the KCCA's Directorate of Legal Affairs for what he said was a sloppy job in defending the authority on this matter, and asked KCCA to recover the land.
It seems, Mr. Chairman, it is a cartel of public servants. Even you had Mr. Caleb the other time saying, ha, these things were done like this, and it is me who told him, please, there are issues which were not followed. And this challenge, this problem, Mr. Chairman, lies in the hands of the Uganda Land Commission.
The Director, Legal Affairs, Caleb Mugisha, however, denied any wrongdoing, instead saying the Office of the Executive Director of KCCA never shared with him the findings of the audit report.
continue with the inquiry into KCCA. A couple of other things have cropped up. There's properties that are under the management of KCCA, which they are really not managing properly, which they are not stewarding as they should.
Story by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.